you are here at our third annual Black History Month program. But we had to slip an extra one in on the first Sunday, and if you missed that one, you really missed a treat. But thank you for being here today. You will definitely be blessed. I am grateful to Millie about 3 years ago when I asked her and John about coming up with some type of a concert series because we have such musical talent that's here a part of our congregation, and how could we share that with the community? And so we started having these concerts, and so it's good to see all of you here. We appreciate you coming. Now, this is a free concert. If you go to the Strathmore, you're going to pay some money, and it's going to be quality. It's going to be quality because we don't have to do anything at university. That's not who we are. And so as they share their gifts and you are blessed, we hope that you will bless us by leaving a donation on your way out today. There are signs for the restroom. Just keep making a right, make a right, make a big box, and you will find your way to the restrooms. And without further ado, we're going to turn it over to Mr. Wakefield and the wife.
With several leading publishing companies. She began writing and arranging out of necessity due to the lack of Carl Octavius in the junior high middle school voice during the first decade of her teaching career. She received a Bachelor of Science degree in music education from Knoxville College, a Master of Education from the University of Louisville, and a Doctorate in Music Education from Columbia Pacific University. The next piece we will hear today was composed by Nathaniel Dent, who grew up in Niagara Falls, Ontario, but ended up living in upstate New York. He is considered one of history's greatest musicians of African descent. He was multi-talented, not only as a composer, but also as a choir leader, pianist, teacher, poet, and writer. During his lifetime, he was lauded as the first African-American composer to fuse Negro folk music with European art music tradition in a sophisticated way. As a seminal figure in the preservation and study of spirituals, both as a writer and choral leader, and as a great teacher and inspirer of African-American musicians and later generations, he is acknowledged to be one of the most important musicians in American history. Please join me in welcoming our own Millicent Scarlett, who will now sing Ride On With Jesus.
Spirituals can uplift, and they can sadden us. They can move us figuratively or literally. They speak to us, and sometimes for us. So today, we will hear some old chestnuts and some new ones. If you feel like clapping, clap. If you feel like crying, cry. Because all of it is welcomed here. Enjoy.
Moore wrote more than 100 compositions, although only about 26 of these students were published in her lifetime. Much of her work was composed in choir or voice, and many of these were inspired by Black spirituals and folk music. Moore once said that she was a teacher who composes rather than a composer who teaches. Let us hear Come Down, Angels.
Yeah.
sacred choral and piano genres have brought him international recognition. Hear his medley of three spirituals. Please join me in welcoming Martha Banks.
Nobody knows.
Other genres in which African-American and Black characters are portrayed can be found in opera, musical theater, and jazz. Today we start with Aida, which is both an opera and a musical. The opera is perhaps one of the most classically recognized pieces that deals with the main Black character. The plot is the Egyptians have captured and enslaved Aida, a Nubian princess. An Egyptian military commander, Radames, struggles to choose between his love for her and his loyalty to the pharaoh. To complicate the story further, the pharaoh's daughter, Amneris, is in love with Radames, although he does not return her feelings. I mean, opera. I mean, seriously. Drama. It was premiered in 1871 in Cairo, Egypt, composed by Giuseppe Verdi. It differs greatly from the musical theater version that was first premiered on Broadway in 2000. Written by Sir Elton John and Tim Rice, the musical originated from a children's storybook version written by the great African-American soprano, whom we in the opera world affectionately call the mother of us all, Leontine Price. In the opera, the first aria that Aida sings is Ritorno Vincitore.
Ritorno
Vincitore! And if you want to hear more, you have to come next year. Occurs when she is alone in the hall. Aida feels torn between her love for her father, her country, and Radames. In the musical, we first hear Aida when Radames' soldiers captured a group of Nubian women, and one of them is Aida. She tries to free herself by outdueling one of his soldiers. Radames forces her to wash his back, but she refuses, saying, although the Egyptians took everything from the Nubians, they will never take their spirit. Now we welcome Zinkle Esamo. Did I say it right? I've been teaching this child for a while and never said her last name. So, to sing, the past is now another land from the musical Aida.
Thank you.
There are many more musicals and operas, even movie musicals, that have African-American and blacks as their main characters. Trumanisha, Even the Lion King, Ain't Misbehaving, Memphis, Dreamgirls, The Wiz, Cabin in the Sky, and most recently, The Color Purple. And that is just to name a few of them. We could spend hours presenting all of this music of which our representation occurs. That might be for another concert, so stay tuned. But I encourage you, if you have never heard or seen any music or seen these shows, please take a listen, because I promise you, you will not be disappointed. Now, let us have a spiritual reflection from Layla. Stagehands and dock workers on the cotton blossom. Its theme includes racial prejudice, the tragic enduring love during racial segregation, and Jim Crow rules. Two of the most famous songs for the musical are Can't Help Loving That Man, which is sung by Julie, a mixed race woman who passed for white, and is reprised by Queenie, the cook of the ship, and who also is Joe's wife, who is the dock worker. Joe sings Old Man River after talking to Noli about her handsome stranger that she met on the boat. He mutters she should ask the river for advice. He reflects on wisdom and indifference. The river doesn't seem to care about the world's troubles, but she keeps rolling along. Please welcome back Nini, and please welcome Brian Jackson.
Thank you.
Corky Invest is perhaps the best known piece of the work that represents African Americans in many musical genres. Composed by George Gershwin in 1934, it is based on the book Corky, written by DuBose Heyward. First premiered in 1935, it is considered a folk opera because Gershwin believed the people in it naturally sing folk music. The character Corky is a crippled street beggar living in the slums of Charleston, South Carolina. He tries to rescue Bess, a woman with a disreputable history, from the clutches of her possessive lover Crown and sporting life, her drug dealer. Today we'll hear selections from this amazing work, Summertime, which is sung by the characters Clara and Bess on a reprise later on in the opera. My Man's Gone Now is a lament sung by Serena after her husband is killed by Crown during a crap game. Corky has a happy-go-lucky look on life as he sings, I got plenty of nothing. At the picnic, Bess and Corky are left alone, and they express their love for each other in Bess, you is my woman now. And then Sporting Life presents his cynical views on the Bible with It Ain't Necessarily So. Welcome, Millicent, Martha, Brian, and Floyd Jones.
David was small.
Ragtime, book by Terrence McNally, composed by Stephen Flaherty, includes music of marches, kickwalks, gospel, and ragtime. Based on the 1975 novel by D.E. Doctorow, it deals with the groups of the early 1920s, African Americans, Upper Suburbanites, and Eastern European immigrants. It premiered in Toronto on December 8, 1996. The three selections we hear today follow the relationship of Sarah and Cole House. They have split up, and in the song Your Daddy's Son, sung by Sarah, she is attempting to explain about her heartbreak, fear, and despair that led her to make a horrible decision to leave her child in the backyard of a rich white woman. Later, Cole House wins her back, and on a picnic, he tells her of his hopes for the future, which were inspired by Booker T. Washington. Together, they sing Wheels of a Dream about the promise of this country and what it can offer to their son. As it goes on, Sarah is beaten to death, and Cole House has vowed revenge. Chaos ensues, and Cole House is holed up in a library. He tells those who have affected his life that violence will not solve the injustice, and charges them to change society through the power of their words and by telling their children their story. That comes in the song, Make Them Hear You. Please welcome Mackenzie and Guy.
Thank you.
Clay. Thank you all for coming today. We are very happy that you spent some time with us. We hope that you come back again next year and bring more people with you. There is a reception in the parlor. Please come, and performers, I've been told by the little one that we are to go immediately to the reception and not be here chit-chatting with each other. So we can chit-chat there. So we don't want to upset Pastor Sherry. So, food, reception, thank you all.